Okay, welcome back to my class. Today we are going to discuss a new topic, that is aggregate supply. In the previous class, we have already discussed the meaning of supply. Supply, all of you are knowing, supply means the quantity offered for sale at a particular price during a particular time by the producer. That is the meaning of supply. But here, what is the meaning of aggregate supply? Aggregate supply means total flow of goods and services in an economy during 1 year. Let us see how it is defined. So, aggregate supply is the money value, of the total output that all the producers are planning to produce during an accounting year. I told you, let us see, this aggregate supply is the total flow of goods and services in an economy during 1 year. So what happens, let us see, when the goods and services are produced, then at the same time, other side, it generates the factor incomes in the form of rent, in the form of wages, in the form of interest, and in the form of profits. And when we'll take the sum total of rent, wages, interest and profit, we'll get the value, and that we call the value of GDP. And that is why this aggregate supply, we can write AS, aggregate supply is equal to the value of GDP. So aggregate supply is equal to GDP. Question arises that how can we measure it? It is measured by two components. We can say two components are there. Components of aggregate supply. Two components are there. First component is consumption, denoted by C. And second one is saving, S. So if we'll take sum total of consumption expenditure and saving expenditure, that will give us the value of GDP, or that will give us the aggregate supply. Let us discuss in detail about these two components. First one is consumption. Let us see how can we define this consumption. Consumption, this is C. Consumption, you are knowing, consumption depends upon the level of disposable income. But another fact we are also knowing, that consumption never be zero. And that is why one formula of consumption is given, C is equal to C intercept plus BY. Here let us see, C means consumption. Consumption depends upon the level of income. But this C-intercept means autonomous consumption. This we have seen, this is consumption. This is autonomous consumption. Autonomous consumption is the consumption which do not depends upon the level of income. Here let us see, this is the Induced consumption. Induced consumption means the consumption depends upon the level of income. Here induced consumption, the consumption depends upon the level of income. If it means the level of income increases, then certainly this consumption will increase. If level of income will decrease, consumption will decrease. So, but this autonomous consumption is the consumption which do not depends upon the level of income. What happened sometime that consumers, they used to use their fast driving, they used to borrow the money from somewhere in order to maintain the minimum consumption. That is why consumption, we can say, never be zero. If suppose we take, if y is taken zero, then what will happen? This c will not be zero. It will be c intercept plus by, here we have taken, then c intercept plus b into zero. So here what will happen? C consumption is equal to autonomous consumption, means consumption is always positive. So consumption never be zero. So this is the first components of the aggregate supply. I think this first component is clear to all of you. Let us see what is the second components of the aggregate supply. The second component of aggregate supply is the saving. The second component is the savings. Saving, you are knowing, saving is the difference between income and consumption. Saving is what? This saving is equal to, we can say, saving is equal to income minus consumption. If you will deduct the value of consumption from income, we will get the value of saving. And let us see, we can derive one equation for saving. This y, the c you are knowing, c is equal to c intercept plus by. B means slope. Slope of the curve, consumption curve, we'll discuss in detail also. So we can write here, let us see, c intercept plus by. We can write it. And let us see, we can write this also, c intercept minus by. We can write like this, or we can write c intercept plus 1 minus by. We can write this also. So what we have seen, saving is equal to minus c intercept plus 1 minus by. This is the formula of saving. So saving, we have seen, saving also depends upon the level of income. Saving is calculated by deducting the value of consumption expenditure from the value of income. So income minus consumption gives us the saving. This is the formula derived for the saving, calculation of savings. So let us see this aggregate supply we can explain by taking one schedule. Let us take one schedule of the aggregate supply. Aggregate supply schedule. We can draw one schedule of aggregate supply. We can draw one schedule. So aggregate supply schedule. Let us see aggregate supply schedule. Here we can take the GDP. GDP means GDP. This is GDP means income. GDP is also denoted by Y. So then we can check consumption. Consumption can be denoted by C. Then we can check saving. Savings S, you are knowing S is equal to Y minus C. Then we can check AS, C plus S. Let us one hypothetical example. I'm taking the units. It may be crores, it may be thousands. So I'm taking the simple units. Suppose the level of income is zero, it increases from 0 to 100, 200, 300, 400, it goes up to how much? 500. So let us see this. If income will increase, consumption will also increase. Let us see, I told you consumption never be zero. I told you C is equal to C intercept plus B, Y. Even if income is zero, consumption is not zero, it will be C intercept. It means consumption never be zero, it will be C is always positive. So similarly, let us see, if income is zero, consumption is not zero, suppose it is how much? 50. When income increases, consumption also increases. When income is 100, consumption becomes 100. Let us see, when 200, 150, then 300, 200, 400 increases from 300 to 400, it goes to 250, then it is 300. What we have seen, when income increases, consumption also increases. But after a certain point, what happened? Increase in income is more than increase in consumption, or increase in consumption is less than increase in income. So because people will start saving, let us see here how much will be the saving. Saving is equal to income minus consumption. 0 minus 50 will be how much? Minus 50. Here let us see, 100 minus 100, 0. 200 minus 150, 50. Here how much? Here 100. Here how much? 150. Here how much? 200. So here what we have seen, first unit if you see, if here consumption, if the consumption is more than the income, then there will be no saving, rather this is negative saving. In economics, negative saving is called dis-saving. So minus represents the dis-saving. Then when income increases, consumption also increases. Here what happened? Consumption and income both are equal. When consumption and income both are equal, then there is zero saving. Zero saving in economics is known by one term that we call that break-even point. We call it break-even point. Break-even point. Break-even point. Break-even point is a point where consumption is equal to income. It means zero saving. It means when the saving is zero, when zero is saving, this point is known as break-even point. So here it is break-even point. So then let us see what happened when income consumption is more than income. Here also consumption is less than income. Consumption is less than income. So when consumption is less than income, there will be the saving. So here saving is 50, 100, 150 and 200. Let us see aggregate supply. How to get the aggregate supply? Aggregate supply is C plus S. Here how much? 50 plus minus 50. Here it is how much? It is 0. Here it is how much? 100 plus 0? 100. Here it is how much? 150 plus 50? 200. Here it is how much? 300. Here it is how much? 250 plus 150? 400. Here it is how much? 500. So if you see this both, what you have seen, this GDP is equal to aggregate supply. We can plot on a graph paper also. Just to represent the relation, we can plot this relation on a graph paper. So let us take, we can plot it on a graph paper. Here we can take 100, 200, 300, 400 and 500. Here we have taken the value of GDP. Here we'll take the aggregate supply. So let us see. Here also 100, 200, 300, 400 and 500. So 100, 200, 300, 400 and 500. Here let us see 100, 200, 300, 400 and 500. So on y-axis we have taken aggregate supply, and on x-axis we have taken the value of GDP. Let us see what happened. 0 and 0, it means here. Here 100 and 100. Here also 100 and 100 if you see. Then 200 and 200. 200 and 200 you will draw. You will get it here. So 300 and 300. 300 and 300. So here also, suppose it will be here. Then 400 and 400 and 500 and 500. So if you join all these points, you will get a curve. You will get a curve. You will get a straight line. This can be, yes. And this curve is known as aggregate supply. And aggregate supply is equal to C plus S. So C plus S means consumption plus saving. Let us see what we have seen. This, if you take any point, you take the 500 GDP, if you take the 500 GDP, if suppose GDP is 500, this represents what? If suppose GDP at this point, GDP is 500, represents that how much is the value of aggregate supply. So the value of aggregate supply is also how much? 500. It means if we take the 400 GDP, the value of aggregate supply is also 400. So this curve, let us see, is the 45 degree line. So at any point, from any point, what will have, if you see the coordinate from any point, you will see the distance from each and every point, both the axes is equal. So I think this aggregate supply, the component of aggregate supply is clear to all of you. Okay, thank you.